A purge stream is a portion of a recycle stream that is withdrawn in order to prevent the buildup of a material that remains entirely in the recycle stream. Such a situation would result in the accumulation of the material, preventing the system from ever coming to steady state. An example of this is an inert species that, since it doesn't react, is never consumed. So let's look at an example of a system first without and then with a purge stream. So we have the reaction to produce ammonia, and this is known as the Haber process. And here is the pertinent reaction. So you have a fresh feed containing stoichiometric amounts of the reactants and an inert gas. This combines with a recycle, forms a feed to the reactor, where you have a fractional conversion of nitrogen. Then the products enter a separator, so we have two different units. The ammonia is removed, the unreacted gases as well as the inert form the recycle stream. We have the feed to the reactor, and we need to find the composition of the fresh feed. So let's look at a picture of the system. Since the feed to the reactor contains a stoichiometric amount of N2 and H2, and 20% is the inert, that allows us to solve for each one of those. So we have 6 moles per second of H2, 2 moles per second of N2, and 2 moles per second of inert. And so we're given a fractional conversion of the nitrogen. So let's solve for that over here. We know that 0.15 is equal to the amount of nitrogen coming in, so that's 2 moles per second, minus the number of moles of N2 coming out, divided by 2 moles per second. And so that allows us to solve for the number of moles of nitrogen coming out, which is equal to 1.7 moles per second. So we use atomic species balances for hydrogen and nitrogen to solve for the other two species coming out. So let's put all of these onto our diagram. Note that I didn't need to put the species right here because the ammonia comes off in this stream here, and the rest of the species are recycled. Note, though, that the inert is still part of the system. None of it has been reacted, so it forms part of the recycle stream. However, if you note, because that inert is 2 moles per second, if we add right here this stream to the fresh feed, that means that no inert can be added. However, if you take a look right here in the problem statement, it says the fresh feed has an inert gas in it. So that means that the inert will continue to build up and the system will not get to steady state. So let's see what happens if we add a purge to the system. So the problem stays the same all the way to the separator, but instead, in this purge stream, we're going to say that 25% of the recycle stream that exits the separator is going to be removed as a purge stream. So now let's put in our quantities. Note the amount of NH3 that exits is the same, but we've split that recycle stream in two portions, one of which is the purge stream right here, and the other which is now the recycle stream that meets the fresh feed. Note that because it's a splitting point right here, the compositions of both of those streams have to remain the same. So now you can see, when we get to the fresh feed right here, that we are able to add an inert every single time and the system is at steady state. So hopefully you can see the necessity of having a purge stream whenever you have an unreactive species in your system.